Well, if we can't call somebody's mama, perhaps we can call somebody's manager.
That would be lovely. This Mr. Sonny Onoo?
Yes.
Hi, Sonny. It's Rick at the Undisputed Wrestling Show. How are you, sir?
Hey, good.
You are live on the air now, Sonny.
Did Ernest come on?
No, he's not come on yet, Sonny. So we'll talk to you for a while, and hopefully the cat will remember us and join us here at a later time.
All right. What's happening, you guys?
Well, first thing, I was going to ask you what's happening. What have you been up to? We haven't, since the last time we've spoken, you've been still traveling all over the place. So what have you been up to?
I am, I just got my boy over to Wilbur College so that he is now the, he's trying to make the team over there for a four-time NCAA, well, four-time in a row NCAA champ, B3. They're 11-time national champ, NCAA national champ, so... you know, I just got him set up. I just got him set up there, and you know, hopefully, he wants to be a national champ. So we'll see what happens.
I tell you what, Sonny, you've been posting a lot this over the summer, and you know, last over the winter time of your son and his accomplishments and the amateur wrestling scene, and good grief, your son can wrestle, man. He's winning a lot of tournaments, and looks like he's got a very bright future in amateur wrestling.
Well, yeah, and you know, and it's interesting that he went to Wilbur College because they have he's going to try to get a degree in digital media production. You know, he makes a lot of videos and movies and stuff, mostly wrestling. So, I mean, that's the field that he wants to get a major in. So, hopefully, wrestling will help him get that. But you know, wrestling teaches so much discipline. And you know, end of the day, it's only martial arts that is fought in the school system or taught in the school system, not fought, but yeah, it's fought as well. but, I think it's a great form of, you know, cause it's so much of self-discipline. I mean, you're not just a wrestler when you're wrestling, you're actually, you know, have to discipline yourself, everything from diet. Cutting weight and all that stuff. So it's very interesting, and I think it's going to go a long way for him. So
let me ask you this, Sonny: what's the odds of your son actually wanting to become a professional wrestler? And if he does want to become a professional wrestler, what would you say to him as the father?
You know, he will most likely. And I think just business is such a tough business. And you know, you're not necessarily the best guy. You're certainly not the toughest guy or, you know, the best fighter. You know, so it's a little, you know, I would discourage him. I think he's interested in doing some MMA, because of my martial arts background as well. So, you know, I think that's the route that he'll, if he does anything after college, that's where he'll be.
So in his wrestling career, has he also done some disciplined arts or anything as well? I mean, has he done judo or taekwondo or karate or anything of that sort as well?
Oh, he does some jiu-jitsu grappling a little bit. You know, not a lot. I mean, but, you know, it comes with a kind of territory when you're wrestling, especially now because of the popularity of UFC. I think a lot of wrestlers dabbles in that. And the grappling and jiu-jitsu tournament is becoming much more popular as well. So, you know.
Very cool. I'm going to kick it over to Zane Paisley. Zane, let's hear what you have to say to Mr. Sonny Onoo here on the Undisputed Wrestling Show.
Hi, Sonny. Thanks for coming on for a second time. We really appreciate you having you on there tonight.
Thanks for having us.
What happened a couple months ago that you got a new wrestling ring? How did that all happen?
Well, Brad Ringen is you know, obviously he's an Olympian he was with AWA as well, and he worked for New Japan Pro Wrestling. That was my counterpart when I worked for WCW doing business with New Japan. And Brad, you know, in his own right, he had schools, and you know, he broke a lot of guys' hands. With AWA and WCW and New Japan as well. And he called me one day and he said, "Hey, Rock is moving, selling his house. And if you want a WCW ring, he says, he'll give it to you. So I said, really? So I went up there, and, you know, I mean, Minnesota is only a couple, 2.5 hours away where he lives, so from my house. So we went up there, and he was generous enough to give me the ring. So now I have a WCW ring.
So Brock Lesnar and Rina Mero are just hanging out there and decide to give you a ring. That's awesome.
I got some photos and memorabilia that they were just getting rid of. They were just moving out, and that's today. Pick whatever you like. But they were really nice.
Okay, so my next question is, you had mentioned New Japan, and we can definitely go into that more, but Zim, all of our listeners of our program know I am a huge mark for Ribera Steakhouse. If I drove out to Iowa to come visit you, would you have an extra Ribera Steakhouse XL satin jacket for me?
You know, I have a jacket. I do have a Ribera jacket. They gave it to me the first time I went there. Have you ate there before?
No, I've never been over. And okay.
Let me tell you what his gimmick of Ribera Steakhouse.
Yeah.
He has a picture of all the wrestlers, right? Autographed pictures, okay? So you think when you go to his place, you see your picture up on a wall, and you go, oh, that's very nice, you know? So what he does, really, is since he knows all the wrestlers who've been to Japan, so what he does is he takes... So what he does is he'll take, he knows you in town, and he put your picture up when you're in town.
That's pretty clever.
You know, so it's kind of funny. He's pretty clever, and he's pretty funny, actually.
The funny thing about it to me is, Sonny, Zane's got this infatuation with Ribera Steakhouse, but from what I understand, and we'll get this confirmed from you or not, is it doesn't really taste very good.
Well, no, it just, you know, I mean, would you want to eat a steak in Japan aside from cold beef? And that's, you know, none of us can afford that anyway.
Right.
So, you know, and it's certainly not the best steak, but it is the best steak that you can have if you're gaijin, meaning you're American, so foreigner who's there, you know, not used to the food and you know, you can't really eat a bento box, what they have for you when you go to the arena. You know, they'll give you all kinds of food, which is an assortment of, you know, fish and some meat and stuff, but not what you guys are accustomed to. So Ribera Steakhouse, and by the way, Denny's over in Shinjuku is a real big deal with the boys. You know, everybody goes there to eat. So it's an interesting combination, you know. I mean, you know, it's kind of like the girl who's rated number 4 on a scale of 10. how she's starting to look real good about 1:00 in the morning. It's kind of like that when you're over there, you know. You will probably poop on a lot of the food that is served over there as American food, like a pizza and stuff. But when you're over there and you haven't had a pizza for a week, you know. You know, anything with a tomato sauce and cheese, you start going for it, you know.
So, Sonny, how active are you staying in the business now? Are you going to shows? Are you participating in shows? Or are you doing any fan fests or any of that sort?
It's interesting because I don't really seek out, you know, my last, you know, 8 years have been with my boy, you know, going from you know, grade school to junior school, high school to high school. And, you know, I've been concentrating managing him, really, and mostly so that he can get a nice scholarship and go to a great school. And we've certainly accomplished that. So I haven't really been freaking out at work. But what's interesting is, you know, and I have done some, you know, autograph signing. Matter of fact, I'm doing one this Friday. I think Ernest Miller and Eric Bischoff is going to join me in New Jersey signing autograph. And week after that, I think I'm in North Carolina doing a show. You know, there's an inquiry for booking for me. So it's interesting. That I get to do that. And I think because of WWE Universe, you know, network channel, the wrestling channel, now that WCW's on, so I'm back on television. So, you know, I can tell by request for autographs and stuff like that I get through the mail that you know, I must be back on somewhere.
Yeah, Sonny Onoo lives forever on the WWE network. You got to love that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's interesting. It's flattering. And it's interesting. And I don't miss the road, but I miss the friendship and certainly the good time we had. And I always knew, maybe because I was a little older and I didn't come from the wrestling business into the wrestling business. Per se, so that you know, I enjoyed and certainly enjoy the moment, and I knew, you know, it was a big tsunami wave we were riding during the time of, you know, 96 through, you know, year 2000. You know, it was a great hype. I think it hasn't been duplicated yet, the popularity of professional wrestling at the time.
This is the Undisputed Wrestling Show. Ernest Miller, the cat, is not with us. However, my surprise for Ernest is here, Sonny Onoo, and we were having a great time talking to Mr. Onoo, as we always do. Sonny, how often do people recognize you when you're walking out in public?
Well, you know, I have always lived in a town called Nation City, Iowa, and a small town in Iowa, northern Iowa. So people in town know who I am, and I mean, I'm very approachable. You know, there's I think people are surprised, even in Kaz, my son's wrestling world, when people find out what my background was, you know, the Sonny Onoo that I played on television. I think, you know, now that we're all on YouTube and everything else, I think, and to see that, I think they're really surprised, you know. And what's really interesting is that, you know, the truth is, between Ernest and between the luchadors and between the Japanese wrestlers that I managed, you know, I was on television, you know, 4-5 times a week. Between Saturday Night TV show, between Thunder, Monday Night Nitro, and certainly on, you know, many of the pay-per-views. So, you know, I mean, I'm just fortunate that I had those opportunities, you know, when it was presented to us back in the heydays of wrestling.
I always thought the cool thing, Sonny, you didn't have a long run, but you had a great run. I mean, you were very memorable. You're a great manager. You definitely got over with the crowd. I guess when you look at today's scene, it's considerably different than it was in the 90s. I mean, managers no longer play such a prominent role outside of maybe Paul Heyman. I guess, what's your thoughts on managers in the business now? Do you think they'll ever make a serious comeback again, or is it just gone in a different direction?
No, absolutely they can. It's all about, you know, all about what writer wants to make it interesting. You know, manager plays a role in a sense that, you know, many times it's Ernest never lost a match. I caused him to lose a match, maybe. but Ernest has never lost a match. I mean, that's the role of manager. You know, and we take the heat and we do the things and this, you know, Ernest probably, and I will tell you, and since he's not here, I will tell you in defense of Ernest that it didn't matter if he won, lost. Ernest always was over. He always got over. You know, whether you loved him or hate him, Ernest always got over. You know, and he was entertaining. He's very smart. And he, like me, he came from martial art background, but he wasn't a wrestler first. You know, I mean, they asked him to be there. Eric asked him to get involved in wrestling. So, you know, even today, matter of fact, Friday, I'm meeting with him in New York. He's going to a karate tournament. He's going to fight there. You know, I mean, he's a legit deal. So it's interesting, you know, getting back to your initial question about managers, you know, a guy like Jimmy Hart and Bobby Heenan, those guys were so kind to me about, you know, teaching me a little bit about, you know, what a role that the manager plays. And you know, even Masahito was the instrumental on a lot of things I did as a Japanese manager. And so, you know, and to answer your question, like I said, they can make it interesting. You know, certainly they made Paul Heyman, you know, very important part of the show. So, you know, without convoluting the storyline, I think you can certainly make it interesting. You know, manager and generals are, we're double crossing, you know, SLB, so.